got this one.
Okay, so my technical title for the district is like school success advocate, but my Madison title is social service, social worker, whatever they want to call it. So what I do behind the scenes is tons of things. So I run the drug and alcohol caseload for the entire school, so hopefully no one gets caught with any of those things. I make all decisions on what your consequence would be. I also deal with every new student that's enrollment and transfer because we have to support new students. Sometimes they come in from other schools. Sometimes they come in with a lot of stories or things from going right, and how do we plug them into Madison and make them feel welcome into our community. I also go through the list of freshmen and other kids that are struggling academically and try to get them on plans to graduate on time. And sometimes I'm just also there, a lot of times, to just connect with students because just a different generation, a lot more trauma. I feel like with this generation of kids, and to be able to be there for support, my door is always open. You don't need an appointment. I get people that come in randomly just because of maybe an issue with a teacher, an issue with another student, something happened on the bus in the morning, a bad relationship, a breakup. And it's not just for women, it's like young ladies. Like, I get guys that come in and just like, oh, can you tell me something about girls? Like, I'm struggling here, you know? So it's just a support service for anybody, even teachers. So it's not just for students. But like, I do a lot of work just to support students and staff in the building. So you never know where I might end up. I might even, because I wasn't our RJ coordinator when I first started here, and I fluently know how to do RJ. It might be something going on really, really big in the school where they need multiple people to come out and do some RJ work, so I might come out and assist with that. Yeah, but that's pretty much what I do. Is there any questions for me? Anybody?
What's the most challenging part of your job?
I would say the most challenging part is when, at the moment, you want it more than the student wants it for themselves. And you know the outcome before they know the outcome, because we didn't all be in our ages. And somebody is going against you or fighting against you, and you're just like, okay, I don't have to necessarily give up, but I have to just fall back, you know? And sometimes I'll struggle with a freshman and sophomore, and if they stay here all 4 years by the junior or senior year, like, we have a good relationship. There's some juniors and seniors did not like me when they were freshmen and sophomores. And now they're, like, always in my office, or I'm their coach. Like, you know, it's like, I'm Coach Shar, and they can see me in a different light. And then I'm pretty sure I get on some people's nerves, but it's all out of love, you know.
What do you enjoy most about your job?
You guys. It's never a dull moment. Like, I love my job. And when you love your job, like, it makes everything so easier in your entire life. Like, some people work these jobs and they get this gut feeling. It's like, I don't want to be there. I want to call off. I don't have that feeling, like, oh, I'm going to work today, but it doesn't really feel like work. I'm working, but it's like, I never know what's going to happen when I walk in here at all. Everything is completely unpredictable. Like, I know what my schedule says, but the moment something, like, pops off or a crisis happens or, you know, we get a false alarm or so, y'all Madison kids, y'all know our school and how it is. So I think that's the best part. And the best part, though, is, like, honestly, y'all keep us young. Like, because whether we like it or not, we're forced in a way to renew, like, what's in style at the time. Like, we can't be stuck in the 90s for, like, when we were in high school, or I'm telling my age, like, you know, or the early 2000s. I'm not stuck in that era. I can't be, because when I come here, y'all are listening to a whole different type of music. You have a whole different type of slang. You guys have a whole different type of style. Some of you guys are taking our style from the 90s, which is totally cool with me. Because if you notice, I've got like 3 pair of overalls that I don't mind wearing around school. But we wore that all the time, and y'all are just bringing it back. So I'm like, hey, you know, this is kind of cool. But so that's also like one of the best things. And I love how diverse Madison is.
What styles of the 90s do you sing
now? So one thing I see, like the flannels, the overalls for sure. There's certain shoes that I've been seeing, like you guys, some of the kids wear that I'm like, man, like, those are actually like, the people bring a Fila back for some reason. Champion, like, went from Kmart, Walmart to like now it's what, 30, 40 bucks or something like that. Y'all bringing it back, not we didn't bring it back, and so now it's expensive. Some of the hairstyles, I'll see some of the girls wear. I'm like, okay, you know, I can dig it. Like, so.
Did you see Heath from 90s Day?
Yeah, so for 90s Day, yeah, I participated in 90s Day with a big jersey over thing, like the, how they used to wear, and baggy jeans, and then I had my Letterman's coat that said 99 on it. Any other questions for me or any of my colleagues?
What are some highs and lows about your job?
Okay, let me go negative first. Lows, sometimes when I feel like we were unsuccessful, like we tried so many things to save a kid and to keeping them here, and we couldn't. Lows, some days is like, I'm a passionate person, I really care. Sometimes I'll get into a mediation and I cry. And I try not, like, I try to be strong in the moment. Sometimes I'll cry when kids leave later. I hold it in for days, and then one day I'm just crying for no reason. It's because I could have cried weeks ago. But sometimes for me, it's because when kids can't control what circumstances are happening to them in their life because of the adults, it makes me like hurt for them, and it makes me upset because I had a good childhood. So I don't understand when kids have bad childhoods, why the adults are so jacked up in their life, you know, and I can't fix that. I can only try to encourage them that it could be better later. And so some of the highs is like when I see kids overcome circumstances and situations and become successful. Highs are when I see a kid bomb freshman year and they graduate on time senior year. Like, highs are, like, kids that got cut from a sports team 1 year and didn't let it discourage them, and they went out the next year and at least tried out again, and they made the team, and they just didn't give up. Or just the things that y'all do around the school, like, the when I see you table and this the Eco Club, and you're trying to save this, and we're going to fundraise for that, just, like, those are a lot of the highs.
Sean, how do you take care of yourself when you just mentioned like all the things that have to do in the day? Like, what does that look like?
Because I'm a mom full time, it's like for me the most important piece is like having days or times when I have a mental timeout. I have to take a mental timeout, meaning like I cannot problem solve because like I'm already problem solved out. So what that looks like is just being able to be in a relaxing place where I don't have to pay, nobody's bothering me, asking me to do anything, and my phone is not really available from somebody that asked me to do anything because I'm just a nice person outside of here. So sometimes like if my friends call and they need something and my kid needs something or family member, it's like you're constantly still helping and going. And so sometimes I just need mental time out. But I have a lot of fun with my friends. I'm very lucky. That I still make time for girls' nights, so we go and hang out, and we do a lot of fun stuff together. Matter of fact, we're going to go out Saturday for adult version of Halloween, and I'm having one of our students like face paint do my face and stuff like that, so that's going to be pretty cool. I just like to laugh and have fun. Huh? One of my cheerleaders, one of my captains, she's really good with makeup. So she's going to do a, like a Day of the Dead thing, but not my whole face, just like the skull around the mouth. So it's going to be kind of cool. And I've got a crazy headband and I've got crazy hair in already to kind of look like I've been shot in like a movie. So. Natural. A lot of the girls, they call me outside of cheer, like, you know, at nighttime on the weekend. They didn't have boy problems. They all come and find me. They have breakups. They come and find me, like, during the day, no matter, you know. And also, like, it's hard because, like, we genuinely care about you guys. So the number one thing I hate is funerals. Like, my thing is, like, unfortunately, I went to a service in September for one of our ex-students, and that was hard. That was super hard, like, super emotionally draining to find out here at work, to spend a day crying, and then to go to the service, like, so, and then you don't realize how much you care about the kids sometimes, like, how much time you spent with the kids until something like that happens, and then you realize, like, you're emotionally impacted. But we do a lot of things. I spend more time at Madison than I do with my own kids. And it's between my day job, coaching, and then, like, there's Saturday school. There's a lot of community events, sometimes with Sun. The best thing is I can bring my kids to those things. If they want to come, my boys are getting older and they have no interest. Like, my oldest will be here in 2 years, so it's really not like. But truly, we do. A lot of us spend a lot of time here. But we make up for it in the summer, winter, spring break with our families. Like, yeah.
Shah, I know you have a meeting at 9, and can I ask you one more question before you have to bolt? This, like, class is part of the curriculum's from PCC, and it's like we're exploring careers in education, and I really try to, like, not just make it about classroom teachers, because every adult in this room is helping make this school work. Mm-hmm. Do you, like, what kind of, like, educational path or training would you recommend for students who are interested in doing the kind of work you do? Like, is there anything out there that you think is really helpful? Like,
yes, I would like to share my journey, because that's... Yeah. It's one of those things, like, it didn't happen overnight. It didn't go to, I wasn't one of those people that just went straight to college. Like, I did Mount Hood, and then I stopped going. And then I was, like, decided to, like, be out of control for a few years. And I just say that because I know what happened. I was like, I'm out of my parents' house. I'm going to do whatever I want to. Because I respected them when I was in their house. I did not disrespect my parents. I was not. So when I got on my own, you couldn't tell me nothing, right? Then I had kids. My first son, I was like, God, like, I gotta get a real job. And then, oh, real job, nobody would hire me. I'm like, I can't even get, like, go to the store, I applied at Babies R Us, and I was like, I can't get a job here? Like, how am I gonna feed my kids, like, and stuff like that? So, my dad and I, we were living together, I said, I'm gonna go back to school. So I went to Mount Hood, back to Mount Hood. Started off in medical, I was like, I don't wanna do this. I'm not gonna be happy doing this. Then I got into the early childhood program at Mount Hood Community College. And then when I was going through that, they try to make you work in a daycare. I was like, look, I don't like little kids. I got little kids. I'm not trying to work with a whole bunch of other little kids. So I was like, you guys need to let me do my practicum with bigger kids. Then they told me that I was too vocal and that if I didn't like how their program ran, then maybe I should pick another field. And I was like, not with 1 year left, like, you can't. So then somebody did some magic up above, because the next year, they stopped making us work in the daycare, and they made us go into a school. So the highest grade I could go into was third grade. I was like, okay, I'll take the highest grade. And even then, they were really little. But it was still fun, and I was like, okay.